to April. This video is for your sun sign. And while you can use it for any part of your chart, this video right here is going to tell you why it is for your sun sign and then how you should also be using, you know, your rising sign, your moon sign to navigate different things like the love video right here that's going to be coming out pretty soon, as well as the career video over here that you can be looking forward to. And so if you want to catch those, make sure that you're subscribed and you hit the notification bell, and let's get started. This month, we're going to look at the general theme, the beginning, middle, and end of the month, what's going to be going super well for you this month, what's your biggest challenge going to be, what you should be avoiding this month, and then the best way to use this month to your advantage, as well as finding out what your crystal of the month is. The decks that I'm using today are the Cosmic Tribe Tarot and the Fuck It deck. If you want information on those, I do have affiliate links in the bottom because a bitch has to get paid. Okay, here we go. Hey, Leo. So what's up for you? What is the general month going to be like in April? And they're like, ooh, feeling tied to icky situations, or, you know, stuck in toxic mindsets or with toxic people or in gross, you know, relationships. You're feeling like you're tied down to something, like you're stuck with something, but the reality is you're not. You're choosing to be there. And that's the hardest part about breaking free of that energy. Like, we're only as stuck as we want to believe that we are, or we tell ourselves that we are, right? I don't know if you guys have seen this meme where it's like a horse that's tied to a plastic chair and he's just like standing there because he has the mindset that he's stuck when really he isn't. He's a fucking horse, right? He can pull anything. So they're like, if you're in this mindset and we don't get rid of that, you're not gonna be fully radiating your like Leo vibe where everybody's attracted to it and they just wanna like give you things and love you and adore you and, you know, make you the center of the universe like you think you should be the center of their universe. And I can say that because I'm a Leo. But they're like, you're just not your nurturing, loving, generous self if we don't snap out of it. So what's the way to snap out of it? And they're like, well, we have to understand that it's not in alignment with who we are. It is not an energy that serves us, that does not make us happy. It doesn't bring us joy. So like, chuck it, right? Why? Why hold on to it? Because we're used to it? I mean, right now, as the stock market plunges, do you say, oh, okay, well, I have $100 left in my bank account. Even though, like, all of my assets are plunging, I'm going to put the last $99 in right now and just hope for the best. No, that's not what you do, right? I mean, you could do that if you had an abundance of extra income and then just wait for it to turn around, right? But we don't just keep doing what we know isn't working. And leave ourselves with nothing left to give. And that's the problem, Leos. A lot of you are doing that, okay? So that's the kind of overarching theme that you want to have in mind for this month. Now, what is the beginning of the month like for you? They're like worry, anxiety, fear. What is the middle of the month going to be like for you? They're like, okay, this is where you hit that 50-50 split. Now, those of you who decide to stay in that mindset, well, you're going to be there and things are going to be a little bit shitty for you. But those of you who can adopt a more carefree, optimistic, anything is possible, including really fucking good things kind of mindset, are going to start to feel the benefit of that. Now, towards the end of the month, they're saying, this is where you get to create things. This is where you get organized. This is where you make your own reality. So based on the mindset that you had, everybody's gonna have a different outcome, right? Now, if you would have stuck to that negative mindset, they're like, you can think all day about what you wanna create, but it's gonna be a lot harder work and it's going to involve a lot more people. You're less self-efficient. Is it possible? Yes, wonderful things can happen for you. But they're saying, you know, we don't have much to tell you as far as like how good of a long-term plan this is going to be for you and if it's what you really truly want. However, if you were more optimistic and joyful and had that childlike mindset as to like, yay, I can do what I want and be what I want and have what I want, they're like, you might not be feeling the immediate benefits straight out the gate, but the details are not really important because things kind of just fall in line for you. That's synchronicities happen. Everything just magically falls into place and it's a lot less grunt work on your part. Just shifting that mindset does you a shit ton of favors. Now, what is the biggest challenge for you going to be this month? And they're like, that fear, anxiety, worry, and actually kind of getting down to the bottom of that one thing that's really holding you back. What is that blockage? Now, I can't tell you that right here in a reading because it might be different for every single Leo. That would be better done in a personal reading, which if you're interested, in the box below, there's a link. But if you're not, like, whatever. Maybe you can figure this out on your own. Maybe you see a therapist or a counselor, you know, whatever. Get to the bottom of it, though, because that's important. Now, what is going to be going super, super well for you this month? And they say the fact that you might not be talking to people that you used to might bum you out, like, straight out the gate. But they weren't helping you get to the end result, to this, like, happiness and, like, all of these goals that you wanted to achieve. And so this creates a space for the right people to step in and really assist you and help put you on the path to getting all of the things that you desire in your life. Now, what is it that you should be doing to use this month to your advantage? And they're like, just keep doing what you're doing on your very own, including working on that mindset stuff. Is there anything that you should be avoiding this month? And they're saying, life isn't fair. You're right. Sometimes things happen. Sometimes coronavirus happens and we don't get to go along with the plans that we had, you know? But you're still an awesome person and you need to come back. Remember in the beginning of the video when I was talking about that Empress energy, you need to come back into that and really shine your light because you are the sunshine in a lot of people's life, even if you don't realize that about yourself. You're important. I think a lot of you know that, but you lose sight of it when you kind of go down this depression funnel. Not that any of you are going to be depressed, but more pessimistic and like, I can't, and making excuses and negativity, and negativity breeds more negativity, whereas you could just be positive and optimistic and have an awesome month. Like I said, watching the career and love videos in specific might give you more insight, but check those out. Otherwise, I'll see you next month.